हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू बाणी स्मार्ट क्लास। दिस इज आलोक, एप्टीट्यूड फैकल्टी फ्रॉम बाणी भुवनेश्वर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ओएससीबी प्रीलिम एप्टीट्यूड टेस्ट नंबर 10। वी हैव लिमिटेड टाइम, वी हैव टू सॉल्व एंटायर क्वेश्चंस, मींस 31 to 65 तक क्वेश्चंस। कम टू दिस क्वेश्चन। In the Axis Bank, total number of candidates 1520. Total number of candidates. In the total number of candidates means employees. Total number of employees. Some employees are male employees and some employees are female employees. Male and female ratio are given 13:6. Okay. We find here number of candidates, male candidates in the Axis Bank. Number of female candidates in the Axis Bank. Okay. In each bank, we have to find how many candidates, male candidates, how many candidates, female candidates. Okay. Now, 1520 total entire employees, this ratio is 13:6. I write here 13:6, 1520 divided by 13 + 6 = 19. You know that 19, 8 is 152, means it is your 80. 13 × 8 is equal to 1040. What is 1040? It is your number of male candidates. Then 18 × 6, 480. What is your 480? It is your female candidates. I think you are clear. Then 4:3 ratio. So total ICICI Bank number total candidates 1680. I write here 1680 divided by 4 + 3 = 7. 7 means 7 × 14, 28. 7 × 4 = 240. 240 × 4 = 960. Then 240 × 3 = 720. Okay. In the SBI, total candidates 1460, that ratio is 9:11. 1460 divided by 9 + 11, it is your 20. 00 cancels, 2 7 = 14, 2 3 = 6 = 73. Okay. Then 73 × 9, 9 3 = 27, 7 2 carry, 9 7 = 63, +2 = 65, 657. 657. Clear? Then 11 73 × 11, 11 3 = 33, 3 carry 11 7 = 77, +3 = 80, 803. I write here 803. Then same HDFC. In the HDFC, total number of candidates here 1380. Then 1380 divided by 10 + 13 = 23, 6 = 138, 60. Then 16 × 10 = 600. Then 13 × 6 = 78, it is your 780. Clear? Then PNB 1420 divided by 13 × 7 = 20. 00 cancels, 2 7 = 14, 71. 13 × 71 = 13, 13 × 1 = 13, 13 × 1 = 13, 31 carry 13 × 7 = 91, 1 = 92. It is your 923. Then 71 × 7 = 7, 7 × 7 = 49, 497. Come to the question. What is the total number of male employees taking all the banks together? What is the total number of employees taking all the banks together? Only you added the total number of male employees. Total number of, what is the total number of male employees? You added the total number of male employees. You added this number, 7 + 3 = 10. 7 3 10 0 1 carry. Then 4 1 5 5 6 11 11 5 16 16 2 18 8 and 1 carry. 10 1 11 plus 9 11 plus 9 20 20 plus 6 26 26 32 32 plus 9 41 41 80 41 80. Option B is your correct answer. Okay. In this type of DI, when ratio is given and ratio summation of ratio data is given, then at first you have to find the, according to the ratio, number of a given data. Number of a given data means here male candidates and here female candidates. Okay. Come to the question number 32. What is the average number of female employees taking all the banks together? What is the average number of female employees taking all the banks together? Okay, clear? Then, total number of employees is female candidate 7 plus 3, 10, 0, 1 carry, 8, 1, 9 to 11, 11 plus 8, 19, 19 plus 9, 28, 8 and 2 carry, 4 to 6, 7, 6, 13, 8, 21, 7, 28, 4, 32, 3, 2, 8, 0. 3280 divided by how many banks here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have to find out the average, means divided by 5. 5, 6 ja 30, 28, 5, 5 ja 25, then 30, then here 6, 656. Option B is your correct answer. In the question 33, question number 33, approximately by what percent is the number of male employees working in banks Axis and SBI together more than that of the total number of female employees working in bank ICICI and HDFC? Male employees working in banks Axis and SBI. Axis and SBI male employees. Axis Bank here male employees 1040. 1040, it is your Axis Bank male employees, and SBI male employees 657. You added this number 7, 5, 4, 9, 10 plus 6, 16, 1697. Total number of female employees working in bank ICICI and HDFC. ICICI and HDFC. ICICI female employees here 720. Then HDFC female employees 780. 780, 80, 20, 100, 0, 0, 1 carry, 7, 7, 41, 15, 1500, 1697, here the total number of male employees banks Axis and SBI, and female employees here 1500, how much more? 1697 minus 1500, 1697 minus 1500, okay, I 7, then 9, 6 minus 5 is equal to 1, 197. How much more? 197 more. How much percentage more? 197, I write here, 197 divided by 1500 into 100. 0, 0 cancels. Then 15 ones of 15, 47, 15 threes of 45. Approximately, it is your 13%. Approximately, it is your 13%. Option D is your correct answer. Then question number 34. What is the ratio of female employees working in bank HDFC to that PNB? Female employees working in bank HDFC. HDFC female employees here 780. Working in bank HDFC to that in PNB. PNB here 497. This ratio of 780 divided by 497 means ratio 780 is to 497. Option D is your correct answer. Okay, clear? Then come to the question number 35. Approximately by what percentage is the number of total employees of a bank SBI more than that of the bank HDFC? Okay. Approximately by what percentage is the number of total employees of bank SBI? Total number of employees bank SBI 1460 more than that of bank HDFC. HDFC 1380. 1460 minus 1380. 0 minus 0, 0. 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. Then 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. 180. 180 divided by 1380 into 100. Okay. If you consider here 1300. Okay. 1300. Then 130. 0 minus 0. 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. Then 80 here, 80 divided by 1380 into 100. 13 6 is 78. Suppose it is considered as 1300. 13 6 is 78. Then 13 7 is 91. But here 80. 13 6 is 78. Approximately here 6%. Approximately here 6%. Question number 35. Yes. 128, 131, 143, 170, 293. These entire questions, it means 5 questions are based on the number series. Okay. You know that number series, there are no formula to find the answer. You have to apply your logic in the question. Which logic satisfied in the question, then you put that logic and get your answer. In the question number 36, 128, 131, 143, 170, 293. 128 plus 3 is equal to 131. I write here 3. First here 3. Then 131 plus 143, 12. 143 plus 170, it is your 27. Okay. Then 3 plus 9, 12. 12 plus 27 means here 15. 9 plus 6, 15. 15, 6 here, 21. 27 plus 21, 718, yeah, 2 to 4. 718, 2 to 4, 48. Then 170 plus 48. Then 8, 7 for 11, 11 carry, 11 to 218. 218 option C is your correct answer. Okay. If you apply the different logic means, different logic here, 128, 131, 143, 170, 293. 128 plus 1 into 3, okay? 128 plus 1 into 3 is equal to 131. 131 plus 2 into 6, 2, 6 are 12. 131 plus 2 into 6, 12. 131 plus 12, 143. 143 plus 3 into 9, 3 9 is 27, 3, 3 2 is 3, 3 6, 6 3, 9, then 143 plus 9 3 is 27, 143 plus 27, 170, 170 plus 4 into 12, 12 4 is 48, 170 plus 48, then 8 for 17 for 21, 218, option C is your correct answer. In this question, 37, 52, 60, 147, 505, 10941. Okay. Then I write here 52 into 1 plus 2 cube. 52 into 1, 52 plus 2 cube, 8, 60. Then 60 into 2, 62 is 120 plus it is 27, 3 cube. Exam clear, I think. Then 147 into 1, 2, then it will be 3 plus 4 cube. 147 into 3. 147 into 3. 3, 7 is 21. 1, 2 carry. 14, 3 is 42. 42 plus 2. 4. 3, 7 is 21. 1, 2 carry. 14, 3 is 42. 2, 44. 441 plus 4. 4 cube. 4 cube means it is your 64. 415, 6, 4, 10, 0, 1 carry. 415. Okay, 505. Then your 505, 1, 2, 3 into 4 plus here 5 cube. Then 4, 5 is 20. Then 4, 5 is 20. 2, 0, 2, 0. 5 cube here, 125. I write here 5. 2, 2, 4. 1, 2. 2, 1, 4, 5. 2, 1, 4, 5. 37. Option A is your correct. In the question number 38, 278, 806, 1070. Then 1202, then 1268, then question mark. Okay. 278. At first we find here difference. This difference we find the difference. 278, 816 minus 8 is equal to 8. I write here 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. Then 9 minus 7 is equal to 2. 9 minus 7 is equal to 2. Then 7 minus 2 is equal to 5. 528. This difference 528. Then 1070, then 806. I subtract here 806. 10 minus 6 is equal to 4. Then 6 is 6. Then 10 minus 8 is equal to your 2. 264. I write 264. Then 1270. Then 2, 10 minus 7 is equal to 3. Then 132. Then 1268, 1202. 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. Then here 6, 66. It is your 66. When you see this series means the difference of the first original series. We find the another series, difference of the original numbers, we get 528, 264, 132, 66. When you observe this line, okay, it is a series. 66 ka double 132, 132 ka double 264, 264 ka double 528. In another way, 528 is a half, means divided by 2. 264 ka adha 132, 132 divided by 2, 66. Now 66 divided by 2, 33. Okay, simply we added here 33. 1268 plus 33. 8 3 11, 1 1 carry, 6 3 9 1 10, 0 1 carry, 12 1 13, 1301. Option D is your correct answer. Okay, clear? Here 1716, 132, 990, 90, then 56. 1716, I write here 12 cube minus 12. 12 cube here 1728 minus 12. Is equal to 1716. This number 1716. Then I write here logic 12 cube minus 12, then 132. 11 square plus 11. 11 square, you know that 121 plus 11. 112, 213, 132. Then here 12 cube minus 12, 11 square plus 11. 12, 11, then comes here 10. 10 cube plus minus 10 cube. Minus 10. Here 12 cube minus 12. 11 square plus 11. 10 cube minus 10. Then 12, 11, 10. That means 9 square plus 9. Then it will be 8 cube minus 8. Then it will be 7 square plus 7. Okay. You know that logic. Then according to this logic we find 90 after 90. 9 square, 10 cube 1000 minus 10. It is your 990. Then 90, 9 square 81 plus 9, 90. Okay. Then here 8 cube here 512 minus 8. 512 minus 8 means 504. Option C is your correct answer. Then come to the question number 40. In this question number 40, 170, 228, 291, 368, then 466. It is your question mark. Okay. At first, we find the difference between these numbers. 172 minus 228. First difference we find 228 minus 172. 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. Then 12 minus 7 is equal to 5. It is your 56. I write here 56. Okay. Here 56. Then 291 minus 228. 11 minus 8 is equal to 3. 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. 63. 56, then 63. Clear, I think. Then 368 minus 291. 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. 16 minus 9 is equal to 7. This is your 77. I write here 77. 77. Then 466 minus 368. 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. Then 15 minus 6 is equal to 9. 98. Okay. 98. First we get the difference between these numbers 172, 228, 291, 368, 466. 172 plus 56, 228 plus 63, 291, these numbers. Then, its difference, 56 minus 63, its difference here 7. 63 minus 77, its difference here 14. 77 minus 98, its difference here 21. Okay, clear? Then 98 plus 7 for that 28. 98 plus 28 added here. 98 7 4 28 here, 28 added here, this number 98 plus 28 880 16 6 1 carry 9 11 1 12 126. Then 126 plus 466 added, 466 plus 126, 6 6 12 2 1 carry, 6 2 8 1 9 4 1 5, 592. Option B is your correct answer. In the question number 41, the total number of students qualified in 2012 and 2014 together. 2012 together, come to this DI, question number 41 to 45. It is very simple DI, try to understand the question and solve the answer. The total number of students qualified in 2012 and 2014 together from school P is what percentage of the total number of students qualified in these 2 years together from school R? School P data and school R data given. School P 2012, it is your 220, and 2014 data 140. Means 0, 426, 213, 360. Then in the R, it is your 200, 2012, then 2014, 320. Add this number 0, 2, 3, 2, 5. 0, then 2, 3, 2, 5. According to the question, 360, P is how much percentage of R? 360 divided by 520 into 100. Okay. 0, 0 cancels. 4 means here 9. 4 means here 13. Okay. 900 by 13. Divide this number. 900 divided by 13. 13, 6 is 78. Then 0. 10 minus 8 is equal to 2. 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. 120. Then 13, 9 is 117. 117 means it is your 3. Okay. Then 69 whole 3 by 13. 69 whole 3 by 13. Option C is your correct answer. Okay. Come to the next question. If the number of students qualified in each year from school A is increased by 15%. And the number of students qualified in each year from school Q is decreased by 5%. What will the difference between the number of students qualifying from school S and Q? If the number of students qualified in each year from school S, okay, is increased by 15%. Here S. We added these 3 years candidates, 160 plus 320 plus 260. Okay. You added this number 0, 6, 2, 8, 6, 14, 4, 1, carry, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 5, 2, 7, 740. What is 740? Total qualifying candidates of school S of 2012, 2013 and 2014. It increases 15%. It increases 15% means it's 15%. 15% means 0, 0 cancels, 15, 4, 60, 0, 6, carry, 15, 7, 105 plus 6, 111. 111.0 means 111. What is 111? Increases. Then 740 plus 111. Here 1, 4, 1, 5, 7, 1, 8, 851. Then, and the number of students qualifying in each year from school Q. School Q. 240 plus 180 plus 260. Added this number. Then here 0, 8, 6, 14, 4, 18, 8, 1, carry, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 6, 680. It decreases 5%. 680, it's 5%. 5%, 0, 0 cancels, 5, 8, 40, 0, 4, carry, 5, 6, 30, plus 4, 30, 4. Then 680, 680 minus 34. 10 minus 4 is equal to 6. Then 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. Then it is your 6. 646. Okay. Then we have to find the difference between these numbers and these numbers. 851 minus 646. 11 minus 6 is equal to 5. Then 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. 8 minus 6 is equal to 205. Option E is your correct answer. Okay, I think clear about the question number 42. Come to the question number 43. Question number 43. If out of the total students qualifying in 2013 from school Q, S and T, 40%, 35% and 45% students respectively got selected for the advanced level competition, what is the total number of students who got selected for advanced level competition from these three schools together? Listen to me. When you read the question in your exam hall, try to read the question only once time. Okay? At first, when you understand the question, then it will be very easy to find your answer. If out of the total students qualifying in 2013 from Q number, Q, S, T, 2013, 2013 is this number, 2013, Q, S and Q, S and T, sorry, Q, S and T, it is not, Q, S and T, T will be 2013, okay, clear? If out of the total students qualifying in 2013 from school Q, S, T, 40%, 35%, 45% students respectively got selected for the advanced level, 40% here, then 35% here, then 45% here. Then 180, it's 40%, 00 cancels, it is your 72. Okay, clear, I think. Then 320, it's 35%, 00 cancels, 35 to 70, 0 and 7 carry. Then 35, 3 ja, 105 plus 7, 112. 112.0 means it is your 112. Then 45, 240, directly 240. Percentage for 0 cancels, 24 5 ja 120, 0 12 carry, 24 4 ja 96, 6 to 8 9 1 10, 108 for the percentage, this 0 also cancels, 108. You added this number, 112 plus 108, 100, 112, 100, 100, 200, 12 plus 8, 20, 220 plus 72, 72. Added this number, 2, 7 to 9, then 2, 292. Which option is your correct answer? Option C is your correct answer. Come to the next question. Question number 34. Question number 34. The total number of students qualifying in 2014 from all schools together is approximately what percent the total number of students qualifying in 2013 from all schools together. 2014 from all schools together. 2014 PQRST, there are five schools. Five schools candidates qualifying students of 2014. First 2014 year 140. Then it is 260. Okay. Then 2014 year 320. Then it is 260, okay. Then here 280, added this number 0, 8, 6, 14, 2, 16, 6, 8, 22 plus 4, 26, 6 and 2 carry, 2, 1, 3, 2, 5, 5, 3, 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12, 1260. What is 1260? This 1260, it is the total candidates of 2014 of the total schools, okay. Then what percent of the total number of students qualifying in 2013? 2013 add 2013, it is your 360, okay. Then it is 180, then it is 240, okay. Then here 320, then here 2013, 240. Added this number 0, this number 0, 4 to 6, 6 for 10, 10, 8, 18, 6, 24, 4 to carry, 3 to 5, 1, 6, 6 to 8, 8, 3, 11, 11 to 13, 1340. 1340 means 1260 divided by 1340 into 100. 0, 0 cancel. Suppose you consider this number is 1 to 6 divided by 1, 3, 4. Suppose I write here 1, 3, 0 into 100. Okay, into 100. 130, because this data is given in the question, approximately value. Then 13, 10, your 130. But it is here 126. 13, 9, 17. 13 9 ja 100 17. Then 117 come to the option. It is 94, 79, 74, 72, 70. This is your 9. This is your 94 percentage. Okay. Option A is your correct answer, because none of these option is not given here. If you find the answer, then simply divide this number 1260 divided by 134. Okay, 1340 or 00 cancels, means 126 divided by 134. If you divide this number, then you will get this answer 94%. Okay, come to the next question. In the question number 45, from school P, out of the students qualified in 2012, P 2012 220. It is your qualified candidates from school fee of 2012. 40% got selected for advanced level competition. It's 40%. 40% means 0000 cancels. Then 4 to 8, 88. Okay. Got selected for advanced level competition, out of which 25% further got selected for the final interviews. It's 25%. 25% means, you know that 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means 88 divided by 4. 22. What is 22? They got the final interviews. Okay. They selected for the final interviews. 22. From school T. Come to the T. Out of the students qualified in 2012. 180. 2012, 45% got selected for advanced level. It's 45%. 45 by 100. 45 by 100 means 00 cancels. 18 5 is 90. 0 9 carry. 18 4 is 72 plus 9. 81. What is 81? They got selected for advanced level competition. Out of which 2/3. 81, it's 2/3. 2/3 means 81 divided by 3 means 27. 27 into 2 is equal to 54. 54 candidates got selected from the final interviews. What is the total number of students qualified in 2012 from these two schools? These two schools means first 22, then it is your 54. 54 plus 22. 4 to 6, 5 to 7, 76. Option E is your correct answer. Okay. Come to the next question. In the following questions, two equations, 1 and 2 are given. You have to solve both the equation. Okay? It is your inequalities. Very interesting things. I think you know these types of questions. Okay? It is very easy level questions. Just I solve this question. 9, it is your 5x square. It is your 5x square. 5x square minus 18x plus 9 is equal to 0. Means, the which number? 9, 5 is a 45. Two numbers, when you multiply you will get 45, and this particular two numbers you will add it, the number is 18. Okay, find the two numbers. 15 into 3, 15 3 is 45, 15 plus 3 18. Okay, 15 plus 3 18, 15 3 is 45, 15 and 3. Here the minus symbol given means minus 15 and minus 3. Here the minus symbol is given, then x value here plus 15, then here plus 3, y value here plus 3, 5x is equal to 15, according to the question 5x is equal to 15, then x is equal to 3, are you clear? I think, then here 5y is equal to 3, then y is equal to 0.6, then x value here 3, y value here 0.6, then 20y square, here square, 20y square minus 13y plus 2 is equal to 0, means which number, these two numbers both are multiplied each other, we get the 40. Then, when the particular number, you added these two numbers, you will get 13. What is that number? 8 and 5. It is 8 and 5. Okay, clear. 8, 5 is a 40. Then 8 plus 5, 13. 20y is equal to 8. This 20. 20y is equal to 8, because minus 8 is given in the value of x, it will be positive. Then y is equal to 8 by 20. 8 by 20 means it is 4, 2 ja, 4, 5 ja, means 0.4. Then here, y value is equal to, here y value is equal to 20, y is equal to then 5, y is equal to 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means 0.25. 1 is 0.4, another is 0.25. 1 is 3, then another is 0.6. Then according to the question, x is greater than y, then option A is the Question number 47. It is a very simple question. X cube is equal to the minus 1878. In this side it will be added 878. 83 11 11 carry, 75 12 1 13 3 1 carry, 84 12 1 13, 1331. 1331 means you know that x value is equal to 11. Okay. Then y square, here y square is equal to 39 plus 82, 9 to 11, 1 1 carry, 83 11 1 12 121. Then y is equal to plus minus 11. Y is equal to plus minus 11, plus minus 11, plus 11 or minus 11, but here only plus 11. That means x is, it is 11 and it is 11, x is greater than equal to 11, x is greater than equal to y, x is greater than equal to y, option B is your correct answer, option B is your correct answer. Are you clear? Then question number, come to the question number 48, listen to me. Here suppose I write x square is equal to 16, x square is equal to 16, x is equal to, I write here plus 4 or minus 4. But x square, x is equal to root over of 16, root over of 16 means x is equal to only 4, only 4. Why? Because x is equal to root over of 16 means there are no symbols here. When in the mathematics there are no symbols, we consider that is the positive sign, okay? But here sign is not given. Sign is not given means we accept that positive sign. Positive signs means positive root over of 16 means the answer is 4. X is equal to 4, okay? Come to the question number 48. Come to the question number 48. 3 by root x plus 4 by root x is equal to x. Then 3 plus 4, 7. 7 is equal to, 7 is equal to x. X, x common, root x. Root x into x is equal to, root x into root x is equal to x. X is equal to 7. Y cube into y to the power of y cube. Then root over of y into a to the power x into a to the power y is equal to a to the power x plus y. But here 3 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 7 to the power 7 by 2. Here y to the power 7 by 2 is equal to 7 to the power 7 by 2. That means 7 by 2 cancels, y is equal to 7. Then option E is your correct answer. Okay. Question number 49, very simple question. 9x, this is the 9x, this is the 4x. 9x minus 4x is equal to 5x. Okay. In the right hand side, it will be addition. In the come to the left hand side, it will be subtracted. Then minus 15.5 here added, 15.45. 55 minus 45, it is 101 carry. Okay. Then 5 for 9, 1, 10, 0, 1 carry, 5, 1, 6, 7. 5x is equal to 70. X is equal to 4. Okay, clear? Then 36, its value here 6 and its value here 7. This 6 comes here, 7 plus 6, 13. Okay. Y plus 155 is equal to 13 square. Because in the left hand side it is square root, in another side it will be square. 13 square 169. Y is equal to 169 minus 155. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. 14. Then x value here 14. 5x is equal to x value here 14, then y value here 14, then x is equal to y. Option E is your correct answer. Then come to the question 50. X square plus 11x is equal to 30. That means x value here, it is plus 6 plus 5. 6 5 is 30, 6 plus 5 is 11. That means minus 6, x is equal to minus 5. Then y here 12, 4 3 is 12, 4 plus 3 7, 4 into 3 12, 4 plus 3 7, this number is a positive sign. Then y is equal to minus 4, y is equal to minus 3. The minus 4 is greater than the minus 6 and minus 5, minus 3 also is greater than the minus 6 minus 5. That means y is greater than x. I write also x is less than y, x is less than y. X is less than y or y is greater than x. Find the options, which option is the correct answer. X is less than y, option C is your correct answer. Are you clear? The quantity of apple, orange, banana in a shop in the ratio 3:6:1. Suppose in that shop apple is equal to 300, banana is equal to 600, then orange is equal to 600, then banana is equal to 100. ओके ऑफ ही परचेज 15% ऑफ एप्पल वी कंसिडर हियर टोटल नंबर ऑफ एप्पल 300 इट इज आर अज्यूमिंग मेथड वी अज्यूम 300 नंबर ऑफ एप्पल 300 600 ऑरेंज एंड बनाना 100 व्हाई वी अज्यूम 300 600 100 बिकॉज फॉर द परसेंटेज 15% फॉर द 15% वी अप्लाई दिस थिंग्स इट्स 15% इक्वल्स टू 45 देन 10% इज इक्वल्स टू 60 देन 20% इक्वल्स टू 20 ओके देन नंबर ऑफ एप्पल्स हियर फ्रूट्स हियर 5 6 टू 8 फॉर 12 125 देन टोटल नंबर ऑफ फ्रूट्स हियर 1000 व्हाट इज 1000 इट इज द शॉपकीपर फ्रूट्स ओके व्हाट इज 125 इट इज बट बाय ऑफ ही इट इज बट बाय ऑफ ही ओके ऑफ ही परचेज 15% 45 देन 10% ऑफ फॉरेन 600 10% 60 देन 20% ऑफ द बनाना 100 का 20% 20 60 प्लस 20 80 80 प्लस 45 125 ओके क्लियर देन द टोटल ऑफ व्हिच वाज 30% लेस देन द टोटल फ्रूट्स बॉट बाय केविन ओके इफ केविन परचेस्ड 100% देन अभी परचेस्ड ओनली 30% लेस मीन्स 70% The total fruits bought by Kevin, if Kevin bought apple, orange and banana in the ratio, it is apple, it is orange and it is banana. If orange 5 times, then banana 7 times. How much less? 2 times less. Then in which number of orange bought are 12 kg less than the banana but. Number of orange but are 12 kg less than the banana but. Orange is 5 times, banana is 7 times. How much less? 2 times less. 2 times is equal to, according to the question, 12. 1 is equal to here, 6. Then total fruits by Kevin, 8 plus 5, 13, 13 plus 7, 20. Then 20 is equal to 26, 120. What is 120? This 120 number of total fruits, it is bought by Kevin. If the Kevin bought 120, it's 30% less bought by Abhi. 120 it's 30% less means 70 120 it's 70% 12 7 84 if the total number of fruits bought by Kevin 120 and Obi 84 according to the question 84 is equal to 84 is equivalent to 125 We assume that 125 fruits bought by Avi, where the total shopkeeper has 1000 fruits. Then 125 is equal to 125 is equal to 84. Then 1000 is equal to what? 125 into 1000 here. 125 is equal to 84. Then 1000 is equal to what? I write here 84 divided by 125 into 1000. 125 8 जा 84 जा 32 2 3 कैरी 88 जा 64 प्लस 3 67 672 ओके द आंसर इज 672 इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 52 वी सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चंस विद द ट्रिक्स मैक्सिमम टू मैक्सिमम 10 टू 15 सेकंड्स टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन ओके जॉन इन्वेस्ट सर्टेन सम फॉर 2 इयर्स इन स्कीम ए offering compound interest 20% per annum. Compound interest 20% per annum for 2 years. 20% per annum for 2 years means it is your 44%. Suppose amount is X, 44% of X, it is your compound interest. Compound interest. Scheme A. It is your scheme A. He also invest less than previous by 1600 in scheme B. For 3 years offering simple interest and 10%. Each year 10% for the 3 years, 30% of suppose another amount is Y. It is your 30%, okay? 30% of Y, it is your simple interest, scheme B, okay? Then scheme A interest 44% of X, then scheme A is 44% of X, then scheme B 30% of Y, percentage I, cancel this number, only 44X divided by 30Y is equal to, A was twice the interest received from scheme B. Suppose B interest is 1 times, then A interest is twice, 2 times. This number also cancels 22. Then I write here 2 means it is 11 and it is 15. Okay. 11x by 15y
is equal to 1 by 1. Then I write here x by y is equal to 15 by 11. This difference is equal to 4. According to the question, 4 is equal to 1600. How much less? 1600 rupees less. 1 is equal to 400. Scheme B here, y. Scheme B here, y. 11 into 4 is equal to 4400. 4400, it is your answer. Option C is our correct answer. Okay.
Each question's contents statement following by quantity 1 and quantity 2. Read the contents clearly and answer your questions accordingly. Okay. Quantity, find the simple interest on, quantity 1, find the simple interest on 32,000 for 3 years at 11% per annum. Simple interest, 11% per annum for 3 years, 33%. I write here 32,000. It's 33%, 33 by 100. 0, 0 cancels, means 0, 32, 3 ja, 96, I write here 6 and 99 carry, 32, 3 ja, also 96, 96, 15, 5, 1 carry, 9, 1, 10, 10, 560, 10,560, it is the simple interest, where the principal is 32,000, time 3 years, and the rate of interest 11% per annum. Then find the compound interest 30,000 for 3 years, 10% per annum. 10% per annum means, you know that for the 2 years it is 21%. 10 plus 10 plus 10 into 10 by 100, 21%, then 10%. 21 plus 10 plus 21 into 10 by 100. 21 plus 10, it is your 31 plus 21, 0, 0 cancels, means it is 2.1. 31 plus 2, 33.1. Okay, 33.1. Then 30,000, it's 30.1%, 33.1%. 0, 0 cancels, this 0, this point cancels, 0, 3, 1, 3, 3, 3, 9, 3, 3, 9. 9,930 and it is 10,560. Option A is, quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Option A is our correct answer. Okay, clear. The shopkeeper sold an article at 20% discount on mark price and he earns 20%. If the mark price of the article is 540, discount, it is your mark price. Discount 20% means 80 by 100, then it is your selling price. In the selling price, 20% profit here, the cost price is 100 by 100. 0, 0 cancels, 42 ja, 43 ja, 3 means it is 180, 180 into 2 is equal to 360. You apply here various tricks to find this answer, 360, okay? Suppose I apply one tricks. One is the cost price, another is the mark price. One is the cost price, another is the mark price. Okay. Suppose mark price here, another, suppose in this question, try to understand the concept, then you apply these tricks. Okay. Try to understand the concept, then you apply the tricks. 540, it is your mark price here into 80 by 100 means 20% here discount. 20% discount. It is your mark price and it is your selling price. It is your selling price and it is your mark price. Here the profit 20%. 20% profit means the cost price is 100 by 120. 100 it is your cost price. 120 it is your selling price. Are you clear? This selling price given, then it is your cost price and it is your mark price. I think you can understand this concept. Okay, then another way we can solve this question. So here cost price and here mark price. 20% discount. 20% discount means cost price here 80. Then 20% profit, it is your 120. Mark price 120, cost price 80. Okay, clear I think. Then 42 ja 80, 43 ja 120. According to the question, 3 is equal to, what I write here, 3 is equal to 540. 3 is equal to 540, so 1 is equal to 180. Then 2 is equal to 180, 2 is equal to 360. What is 360? This 360, it is your cost price. 360, it is your cost price. Then, come to the second quantity 2. Quantity 2, apply also these tricks. The shopkeeper marks the price of the books 450. It is your 450. And his profit percentage is 25%. Find the cost price of the book if you allow a discount of 10%. Discount of 10% means 90 by 100. It is your selling price. 25% profit means 100 by 125. This number cancels. 5 means it is 525. 5 is 125. 5 means it is 90. Okay. Then 5, it is 5 is 25. 5 18 is. Then 5 also it is here. 18, 18 into 18 is equal to 324. This quantity to value 324. 324. Then quantity 1 value 360. The 360 quantity 1, quantity 2 is 324. Quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. 360 is more than the quantity 2 means 324. In another way, we solve these questions in the technique. Suppose question quantity 2, the shopkeeper marks the price of the books 450 and his profit is 25% discount. Profit is 25%. Profit is your 25%. Find the cost price of the book if you allow a discount of 10%. Here discount is 10%. We apply that tricks. Listen to me. 25% profit, I write here cost price and here mark price. 10% discount means 100 minus 10 is equal to 90. It is your cost price. We consider this. And 25% profit means it is your mark price 125. If you cancel this number, 5 it is 18, 5 it is 25. According to the question, mark price is 450, then 25 is equal to 450, so 1 is equal to 450 divided by 25, okay? Then it is 18, 25 into 18 is equal to 450, 18 is equal to 18 into 18 is equal to 324, okay? Try to solve these questions in the various methods. There are 4 to 5 methods to solve these questions. Which method is best method for you? You apply that tricks. In the next class, I will give you some extra technique to solve this type of questions. Today, I have no time. Then, I solve only this method to get this answer. Okay. Then, come to the next question. Question number 55. In the question number 55, a bag contains 4 pink, 7 yellow and 5 black balls. Total number of balls here, 7, 4, 11, 5, 16. If 3 balls are done randomly, then find the probability of getting 2 yellow balls and 1 pink ball. 2 yellow balls means 7C2 into 1 pink ball, 4, 4C1 divided by 16C2. 7C2 means 7 into 6 divided by 2. 2, 3 ja, 7, 3 ja, 21. Here 4C1 means 4. 21, 4 ja, 84. 16C2 means 16C3 means 16 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 13 factorial. 16 into 15 into 14 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. Then 3, 5 is a, then 2, 7 is a. 16 into 7, 5 is a 35. 84 divided by 16 into 7 into 5. 7 means it is 12, then 4 it is 3, then 4 it is 4. 5, 4 is a 20, 3 by 20. The quantity 1 answer is 3 by 20. Okay, clear? Come to the quantity 2. Quantity 2. In the quantity 2, if two balls are done random, then find the probability of getting both the balls are either pink or black. Pink 4C2 divided by 16C2 plus black ball here 5C2 divided by 16C2. 4C2 means here 4 into 3 divided by 2, 2, 3 is 6. 3 to 6, 16 2 means 16 into 15 divided by 2, 2 8 is 15, 8 is 120, 16 divided by 120 plus 5C2 means 5 into 4 divided by 2, 2 2 cancels, 5 to 10, 16C2 means 120, 10 plus 6, 16 by 120, 4 means it is your, 8 means 2, 8 means here 15, 2 by 15. The 3 by 20 and 2 by 15, which is more? 3 by 20 is more. The quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Okay, clear? Then come to the next question. A man covers a certain distance, it will 1 by 3 hours. He covers first half of a distance 12 km per hour and a second half of a distance 18 km per hour. In the various ways you solve these questions, I will give you the shortcut tricks. 12 km per hour and 18 km per hour. 12 and 18, its LCM is 36. 12, 3 is 36, 18, 2 is 3 to total is 5 hours. In the 5 hours, he covers 36 km, okay? In 8 1 by 3 hours means 25 by 3 hours he covers 36 by 5 into 25 by 3. 5 5 is 25, 3 is 36, 12. 12 5 is 60. 60 kilometer, the first half is 60 and the second half is 60. Total distance is 120 kilometer. Half of the distance he covers the first half of a distance, one half is 60, then total is 120 kilometer. Then come to the next quantity 2. In the quantity 2, two trains of equal length moves towards each other at a speed of 40 km per hour and 35 km. If they are crossing each other, equal length, suppose one is x, the another is x, equal length in the relative speed, x plus x, total distance here 2x. Total distance here 2x, two trains of equal length moves towards each other at a speed of 40 km per hour and 35 km towards each other means opposite direction relative speed 40 plus 35 is equal to 75. That means 2x divided by 75 into 2x is the 2x it is your distance, 75 it is your speed. The speed meter per second, 75 into 5 by 18 is equal to 14.4. Distance by speed is equal to time. This distance 2x divided by 75 into 5 by 18, it is meter per second 14.4. Okay. Then 2x is equal to 14.4 means here 7.2. Then x is equal to 7.2 into 75 into 5 by 18. 75 into 5 by 18. Okay, 2 means it is 9, then 3 is 3 means it is 25, 5 is 125 by 3. 125 by 3 means it is the less value than 120. So that quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Option A is our correct answer. Quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. In the quantity 1, the ratio of speed of two trains is 4:7. If the second train runs 392 km in 7 hours, 7 hours it covers 392 km. In 1 hour it covers 75 ja 35. 35 means 42. 76 ja 42. Okay, 56. 56, the ratio of speed of two trains is 4:7. When the speed of the two trains is 4:7, if the second train runs 392 km in 7 hours, then the speed of the first train, 56 km per an hour, it is your speed of the second train. 4:7, according to the question, 7 is equal to 56, then 4 is equal to 7 is 56, then 4 is 32. The first train speed is 32 km per an hour. 120 meter long train cross a pole in 4 seconds. In 1 second, it covers 120 divided by 4. In kilometer per an hour, speed is 3600 seconds, okay? 4 means it is 30, then 0, then 0, 36 is 108. It is your 108 kilometer per an hour. So that quantity 2 is greater than quantity 1. Option C is your correct answer. 450 chocolates were distributed equally among children in such a way that the number of chocolates received by each child is 20%. Of that of the total number of children, how many chocolates did each child receive if 10% of chocolates are taken back by teacher? Suppose 450 is your total number of chocolates. 10% chocolates taken by teacher means it is 90% of the total chocolates. It is distributed among the students. 9 5 is 45, 5 4 carry, 9 4 is 36 plus 4, 40, 405. These 405 chocolates distributed among the students. But according to the question, in such a way that the number of chocolates received by each child is 20% of that of total number of children. Suppose total number of children X. Each child gets X ka 20% means 1 by 5 means X by 5. Each person get x by 5. According to question, x into x by 5, it is the number of students, and this is x by 5, it is the number of chocolates. Number of students into number of chocolates is equal to total number of students distributed among the students, 405. X into x, x square is equal to 405 into 5, means 5 is 25, 5 is 20, 2025. X is equal to 2025 square root, it is 45. What is 45? X value here, 45. How many chocolates did each child receive? How many chocolates did each child receive? Means total number of students, 45. Each child gets 20% of the total number of students. 45 is 20%, means 1 by 5 is equal to 9. Each child gets 9 number of chocolates. Are you clear, I think? Question number 59. Okay. In the question number 59, A took 20 seconds to cross a rectangular field diagonally, walking at the rate of 68 meter per minute, and B took the same time to cross the same field along the side, walking at the rate of 50 meter per minute. The area of the field is dash. Area of the rectangular field means length into breadth. It is your rectangle. A took 20 seconds to cross a rectangular field diagonally, walking at the rate of 68 meter per minute. 1 minute is 60 seconds. In 60 seconds, he covers 68 meter. In 1 second, he covers 68 by 60. But he took 20 seconds to cover diagonally into 20. 20 means it is 3. 68 by 3. What is 68 by 3? It is the length of the diagonal. 68 by 3. A took 20 seconds to cross a rectangular field diagonally, walking at the rate of 68 meter per minute. And B took the same time. B took the same times means 20 seconds. 20 seconds. B took 20 seconds to cross the same field along its side, walking at the rate of 50 meter per minute. Per minute means 60 seconds, it covers 50 meter. In 1 second, it covers 50 by 60. Okay, clear? But it takes 20 seconds to cover the one side into 20. 50 by 3 meter. What is 50 by 3 meter? Suppose breadth is 50 by 3 meter. The diagonal is given, length is given. Suppose 50 by 3 is your length, okay? 50 by 3 is your length, and the diagonal is 68 by 3. Then length is given 50 by 3 and breadth is given 68 by 3. Then, diagonal is given 68 by 3. Length is given 50 by 3. Then breadth is equal to diagonal square minus length square is equal to breadth square. Diagonal means it is 68 by 3 square minus 50 by 3 square, its root over. 68 means 68 square, 8 square 64, 6 square 36, 8 6 is 48, 2 is 96. You added this number 4, 6, 6, 12, 2, 1 carry, 9, 6, 51, 16, 6, 1 carry, 3, 1, 4, 4, 6, 2, 4. Then 50 square, 2500 subtracted, we get the 4, 2, 6 minus 5 is equal to 1, 4 minus 2 is equal to 2, 2, 1, 2, 4. 2, 1, 2, 4 divided by 9, 2, 1, 2, 4 divided by 9, 2, 1, 2, 4 divided by 9, okay. It is your 2, 1, 2, 4 divided by 9 means it is root over, okay. 2124 divided by 9, cancel this number, 4, 213, 3251, 9, it will be cancelled, 92 is 18, 32, 93 is 27, then 54, 96 is 54, 236, what is 236? 236, it's root over, 236, it's root over, 15 square, 225, 16 square, 256, but here data is given 235. Suppose we take that 15, another is 50 by 3, 35 is 15 to 5, 250, just more than 250, which number? 256, option B is our correct answer. Are you clear? Come to the next number. Question number 60, the difference between the age of Rohit and Angela 3 years ago was 12 years, listen to me. Difference of the two friends here, Rohit and Angela, 3 years ago was 12 years, then 2 years ago also 12 years, after 2 years also 12 years, difference always the same, 3 years before same, 2 years after same, 4 years before same, and 10 years, 100 years after same, okay. Then 3 years ago was 12 years difference of the Rohit and Aguila. If the ratio of their age is 9 years hence is 7:4.
7:4, this difference is equal to 3. According to the question, 3 is equal to 12, 1 is equal to 4. Then 7 is equal to 7 for 28. 28. This age is Rahul's age, Rohit's age. 7 for 28. Rohit age is 28. Rohit age is 28. After 9 years, 28. The present age is. Present age is 28 minus 9 is equal to 28 minus 9 is equal to 28 minus 9. 18 minus 9 is equal to 9, then 1, 19. Okay, 19. Find the present age of the Rohit's mother who is 25 years older than the Rohit. Then 19 it is the age of the Rohit. And his mother 25 years older. Means mother age is 19 plus 25. Is equal to 44. 59, 14, 4, and get 1, 7, 4. 44. Option D is your correct answer. Come to the next question. Question number 61.
The speed of the two trains is in the ratio 3:4. They are going in opposite direction along parallel tracks. If each takes 3 seconds to cross a telegraph post, find the time taken by the trains to cross each other completely. 3:4. Suppose the speed of the two trains is in the ratio 3x. 3x was meter per second and 4x it is meter per second. It is speed and it is meter per second. It is also speed. They are going in opposite directions along parallel tracks. If each takes 3 seconds to cross telegraph, it is 9x meter. It is the length of the first train and it is 12x. It is the length of the second train. I think you are clear. 3x meter per second is the speed and 4x meter per second it is also speed. It takes 3 seconds. The distance covered by speed into time is equal to distance. 9x meter it is the length of the first train. Same thing here. 4x it is your speed. It takes 3 seconds. 12x meter. 12x meter it is your length of the second train. The total both the trains length 12 plus 9 21x meter. 21x meter. Find the time taken by trains to cross each other completely. Both the trains comes in the opposite direction. When in the opposite direction, the speed of the two trains will be added in the relative speed. 4x plus 3x divided by 7x. It is the distance. It is the speed. The time is equal to 3 seconds. It takes 3 seconds to cover completely. Okay, clear. Question number 61, clear. Question number 62, 63, 64, 65. These four questions, based on the calculation, try to solve these questions. When you practice this calculation, then it will be helpful for your exam. In the exam hall, you will be solve all that questions if you have practice. Otherwise, you can solve that questions. 62, 63, 64, 65 is your calculation oriented question. Try to solve these questions. It has, I think, these questions no doubt. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.